Have you ever wondered what makes streetlights turn on at night and off during the day? Hey guys, in this video, I'll walk you through step by step how to build a streetlight circuit using a 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 4 jumper wires, 1 10,000 ohm resistor, 1 LDR, 1 LED, 1 555 timer IC. A battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source. A breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode. Monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Insert the LDR into pin 2 or trigger in pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 10,000 ohm resistor. Insert the 10,000 ohm resistor into pin 1 or ground and pin 2 or trigger. Insert an LED into pin 3 or output and the negative rail. The positive lead is in pin 3. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. As you can see, the LED turns on when it's dark and turns off when there is light. To make the circuit more adaptable, you can replace the 10,000 ohm resistor with a potentiometer. This lets you fine-tune the light sensitivity so you can control exactly how dark it needs to be before the LED turns on, rather than relying on a fixed threshold. As I adjust the wiper on the potentiometer, the circuit becomes more sensitive. The LED turns on with less need to cover the LDR. If I turn it even further, the LED stays on even in bright light. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This circuit is an automatic streetlight system that uses a 555 timer IC to control an LED based on ambient light levels. Four AA batteries, or 6 volts, are connected to power the circuit. Pin 8 of the 555 timer receives this voltage, and pin 1 is connected to ground. It works by using an LDR, or light-dependent resistor, in combination with a 10,000 ohm resistor to form a voltage divider that senses the surrounding light. An LDR is a special type of resistor that changes its resistance in response to the amount of light falling on it. It's also called a photoresistor. The key idea is simple. Its resistance decreases when light increases, and its resistance increases when it's dark. The LDR is made from a material like cadmium sulfide, which is sensitive to light. In bright light, the material becomes more conductive, so the resistance drops, sometimes to just a few hundred ohms. In darkness, the material becomes less conductive, so the resistance rises dramatically, sometimes up to several mega ohms. This behavior makes the LDR perfect for light sensing circuits. The junction between the LDR and the resistor is connected to pin 2, or trigger of the 555 timer. During the daytime, the LDR's resistance is low because it receives light, causing the voltage at pin 2 to remain high. This keeps the output at pin 3 of the 555 timer low, so the LED stays off. At night, when there's little to no light, the LDR's resistance increases significantly. This causes the voltage at pin 2 to drop below 1/3 of the supply voltage, which triggers the 555 timer. Once triggered, the 555 timer sets its pin 3 or output to high, which turns on the LED. The LED remains on as long as the voltage at pin 2 stays low. That is, as long as it's dark. When the sun rises and light hits the LDR again, its resistance drops, the voltage at pin 2 rises, and the 555 timer's output returns to low, switching the LED off. This design effectively mimics the behavior of real-world streetlights, turning on at dusk and off at dawn, making it ideal for low-cost automation projects. I hope this video has shown you how to make a streetlight circuit with a 555 timer. Would you like to see another approach to this? An alternative to using the 555 timer is a circuit based on a BC547 transistor. It performs the same basic function, turning the LED on in the dark and off in the light, but uses the transistor as a switch instead of the 555 timer. Check out this other video linked in the description below. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.